ओके, टॉपिक नंबर 4 इज प्रोपोर्शनल्स एंड डेराइविंग इक्वेशंस। फॉर एग्जांपल, एफ इज इक्वल टू एम ए, विच वन इज कांस्टेंट? जनरली मास ऑफ द बॉडी कांस्टेंट, फोर्स प्रोपोर्शनल टू एक्सेलरेशन। देन एफ वन बाई एफ टू इज इक्वल टू ए वन बाई ए टू। टाइम पीरियड ऑफ पेंडुलम 2 पाई रूट ऑफ एल बाई जी। ऑन अर्थ जी कांस्टेंट, देयरफॉर टी प्रोपोर्शनल टू रूट एल। देयरफॉर यू हैव टू राइट टी वन बाई टी टू इज रूट ऑफ एल वन बाई एल टू। इफ यू नो दिस वन, यू आर एबल टू डू द प्रॉब्लम्स। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इनिशियल टाइम पीरियड ऑफ पेंडुलम इज टी, लेंथ ऑफ पेंडुलम डबल्ड, अंटे एल वन इज एल, एल टू इज टू एल। What is the final time period t dash? How much? Question is this. Then, if you know the relation between time period and length, t1 by t2 is root of l1 by l2. So, t by t dash is equal to root of l by 2l. So, ll cancel, we are getting 1 by root 2. Therefore, t dash is equal to root 2 t. So, time period increased by root 2 times. In many concepts, we can get this type of formulas. For example, Young's modulus FL by pi r square E. Generally, Young's modulus depends on nature of material, so it is a constant. Or they said two wires made of same material means Y constant. Then constant means you have to write F1 L1 by r1 square E1 is equal to F2 L2 by R2 square E2. So, whatever the data they given, you have to substitute and you have to calculate the ratio whatever they are asking. Like that, resistance of a wire rho L by pi R square. So, two wires made of copper material, lengths L1 L2, radii R1 R2, find the ratio of their resistances. So, resistance ratio is required. Rho depends on nature of material. R1 by R2 is equal to L1 by L2 into R2 square by R1 square. Suppose in the problem, the lengths are in the ratio 2 is to 3. Radii are in the ratio 1 is to 2. Find the ratio of the resistances. Therefore, R1 by R2 is equal to 2 by 3 into R2 square by R1 square means 2 square by 1 square. We got 8 by 3. So, resistances are in the ratio 8 is to 3. Like that, in each and every problem, we get this type of relations. So, this one is one of the important topic. For example, coefficient of viscosity in Poiseuille's equation, Poiseuille's experiment, pi p r power 4 by 8 v l. Eta is equal to pi p r power 4 by 8 v l. Therefore, we can write eta 1 by eta 2 if you want p 1 by p 2 into r 1 power 4 by r 2 power 4 V2 by V1 into L2 by L1. So, only the concept you have to learn in physics. After that, you have to do the problem by using mathematical concepts. Proportionals. So, eta 1 by eta 2, P1 by P2, R2 power 4 by R, R1 power 4 by R2 power 4. So, like that, you have to obtain the relation and they can give the data, you have to substitute. So, physics part is, what is this formula, what are the terminology, how we got it, that's all. Then, comparison, you have to do by mathematical concepts. So, this is proportionals and very much useful in physics. For example, height of ascent, u square by 2g. Then, h1 by h2, u1 square by u2 square, because g is a constant. Then a body projected with speed u rise to a height h. If it is projected with double the speed, what is the height raised? Then use this formula and substitute the data. H1 is HA. H2 you have to calculate. U1 square by U2 square. U1 square means U square. U2 square means 2U whole square. Ante 4U square. So U square cancel. Therefore H2 is equal to 4H. The height raised by the body if it is projected with double the velocity is 4 times that of the initial height raised. So proportionals can be used in each and every chapter and very much useful.